Lisa has been saying all day about how she hadn't prepared a speech and how bad it was going to be, and I, which was great for me because I knew I was following her. That's a tough act to follow. But as many of you know, I am Max's taller, better-looking younger brother. And being Max's younger brother, I was often the benefactor of his mistakes and his successes. I got to watch as he experienced the world, and I based my own experience off of what he did. When we were little, once he boasted to me that he could do a half of a flip off of our bunk bed. Well, I challenged that assertion, and damn if he didn't get up on the top of that bunk and do a half flip. Unfortunately, a half of a flip is basically just a nosedive. That didn't end up working out very well for him. But I can proudly say that I have never once attempted half a flip. And I have my brother to thank for that. Growing up, I always believed that all these things about Mac, these little quirks that I love, I always believed that one day when he found the love of his life, she would have to love him in spite of these things. And don't worry, I've got some examples. First of all, regardless of whether Mac is going to a dive bar in the summer or a... Yeah, I think he already knows. Or a church service in the winter, Mac is going to be wearing shorts, a t-shirt, and flip-flops. If he's feeling particularly dressy, he might wear black socks with the flip-flops. If he's feeling particularly cold, he might wear that gross teal hoodie that I think my dad wore in the 1980s. The mere fact that he's not wearing that right now is just a testament to how much he loves you. Another example, my brother, when it comes to physical activity, he becomes the Incredible Hulk. And I don't mean that in a good way. I mean that in a psychotic, dangerous way. An example, and this is an example Scott was trying to use last night. Once in a pickup game of basketball at Rams Head when he was in college, I was not there, so I cannot give you the exact details of how this happened. Somehow, my brother kneed some poor fellow in the head so hard he was knocked out cold. He had to be taken out on a stretcher and treated at the hospital for a concussion. There are a number of people in this audience today who have played basketball with Mac, and I'm sure you all have your fair share of bumps and bruises and cuts and scars and scrapes from that experience. I myself have a more unique understanding of that. This was about a year and a half ago. My brother had gotten really into weightlifting, and he's getting really buff, he's getting really big, and me being the taller, better-looking brother, I said, he's catching up on me. I gotta run this guy down. So I decided to start weightlifting with him, and he's all about squats and deadlifts. Squats and deadlifts. Those are the two. If you're gonna do two lifts, squats and deadlifts. I've never done deadlifts before in my life, but for those of you who don't know, That's about what you're doing. So we go into the gym, and he's squats. Come on, man, we got to do some deadlifts. I've never done deadlifts before. So we do the first set. I make it through all right. I'm feeling pretty good. We put a little more weight on. Go through the second set. After the second set, I'm feeling a little queasy. My legs are feeling a little shaky. But, okay. All the while, though, I had this little encouraging voice in my ear. This is my loving brother. My ears saying, "Don't be a wimp. Come on, don't be a wimp." He didn't say wimp, but I was told to censor myself. I wasn't a wimp. I finished out this set. I felt good about myself. I felt a little sick, to be honest, but I also felt good. 2 days later, I was admitted to the hospital. This is not a joke. For 6 days. With rhabdomyolysis and two bulging discs in my back. My doctor recommends that I don't work out with Mac anymore. I have not since. But these were all things that I always believed that, like I said, some poor woman would just have to put up with these things. And she would love him in spite of them. But the latest lesson that I've learned from my brother and my new big sister is that true love is not when you love someone in spite of their faults. It's when you love those faults almost more than you love the things that attracted you to them originally. And because those are the things that really make you who you are. And so on this auspicious day for love, let us raise our glasses to Mac, to Alicia, to true love.
Yeah.